हेलो व्यूअर्स, इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई टॉक्ड अबाउट मिस्ट्री एंड मिरेकल प्लेस एंड नाउ इन द सीक्वेंस I would like to speak on morality, please. As far as the history of British drama is concerned, we need to go back to the pages of history in order to understand British drama in totality. If you really see the British drama today in the 21st century and gradually go backward, you will find the roots of English drama over there in the mystery, miracle, and morality plays. Now I would like to talk on morality plays. The morality play is actually the lateral stage in the development of English drama. In the previous lecture, already we talked about what is a mystery play, and subsequently, we also discussed about the miracle plays. Now the lateral development is about the morality plays. Just like the mystery and miracle plays, the morality plays were basically didactic in purpose, but mostly the dramas had personification of abstractions such as mankind, mercy, peace, good and bad angels, and so on and so on. In these morality plays, the devil plays a very, very important role, and of course the plays lead to the possibilities of tragedies. Similarly, you find the elements like vice and virtue. Vice is shown as the humorous character, and the hero is generally the personification of various human qualities. And once you say various human qualities, of course you need to accept that, or you have to accept that the human being has good and bad qualities both. The morality plays were never part of any cycle as such. On the other hand, they are developed independently as moral tells in the late 14th century and the early 15th century. And specifically, I'm talking about Europe as a continent and England as a country. I'll be confined to this only. So the morality plays do not illustrate the incidents, events, stories, moments from the Holy Bible. They do not describe the life of Jesus Christ or any of the saint also. On the contrary, the morality plays describe the lives of people facing different temptations of the world. These plays are careful to present a warning to the unwary that their souls are always in peril, that the devil is on constant watch, and that the people must behave properly if they are to be saved. See the fundamental concept behind the morality plays. They neither refer to the Holy Bible nor to the lives of the saints, but on the contrary, there is a fundamental concept of vice and virtue, good and bad, right? And based on this concept only, they try to make reforms in the society by threatening the people that if at all you do good, something good will happen to you. If you are the follower of Satan, you will be punished. This sort of concept was adopted. Later, allegories were introduced in the morality plays. As far as the examples are concerned, I would like to quote the allegory that can be found in the play, in the castle of Perseverance. Similarly, you have Mankind, which is a very short morality play, whereas you have Every Man, which is a masterpiece and is one of the best examples of the morality plays. Actually, Every Man is a personified Christian virtues and vices. As they baffled with one another for control of a mortal soul, these plays explicitly designed to teach a moral lesson to the people in general and improve their behavior in their day-to-day lives. So already it is right in the beginning told that it has a didactic purpose. All these plays are allegorical, and the characters therein are personified abstractions of different human qualities. If you go beyond that and get into the details of the morality plays, you will find that The morality plays are considered to be very important in the development of English drama. And there is the fundamental reason behind it. Those plays become free from the sole control of the religion and the church. See the difference here. Mystery plays, miracle plays, and morality plays. Stage 1, 2, 3. The stage 1, which is purely based on the stories and events from the Holy Bible, and of course, the control was there in the hands of the church authorities. The subsequent development that we saw in miracle plays, the subject matter of the play was confined to the various miracles performed by different saints. And of course, it was also partially controlled by the church, and to some extent the control went to the hands of the people as well. But the speciality about the morality plays is these plays have become totally free from the sole control of religion and church. The dramatists were given freedom in the choice of the theme and characterization. They did not remain confined to the scriptures of the religion. Their themes and characters were not brought basically from the lives of the saints and the life of the Jesus Christ. At a larger level, when you look at it, this factor became instrumental in the growth of English drama. Later, the morality plays were called Tudor morality plays, which were in contrast with the early morality plays. See, the early morality plays had the didactic purpose. The vision was very clear. But the Tudor morality plays, of course, they also continued to be didactic in nature of the original morality plays, but they become more secular in theme, characterization, dramatization, and so on and so on. I would like to give a few examples in this respect. You have the morality plays like Magnificence, The Four Elements, The Satire of the Three Estates, King Jehan, and so on and so on. So this is how this morality play, or the morality plays as a whole, plays an important role in the process of the development of English drama. And unless you come to know about the basic principle of morality plays and how it actually worked during the early stage, and even when the Tudor morality plays were introduced, you will not be able to understand the subsequent development of English drama. So once you understand the basic principle of morality plays in continuation to the mystery plays and miracle plays, I think leading to the overall history of modern English drama will not be a complete one.